is Jeff Miller. I'm a math teacher at Gulf High School in Newport Richey. I've been here since 1995. And I do the school website, which I update almost every day. It has hundreds, maybe thousands of photos and videos of sporting events. I usually go to the football games and do a highlight video. And also information about the history of Gulf High School. I worked in radio broadcasting for the first half of my life. And then about 1990, I thought I would like to become a teacher, so I sort of changed careers. And I worked for WGUL radio station in Newport Richey. I came here to get out of the snow from West Virginia. And so I wound up getting hired by Gulf High School in 95. I taught at River Ridge for about a year in 1992-93. I've been interested in doing web pages really since before I became a teacher, I think. And I had done a web page on the history of Pasco County. Actually, it started out as the history of Newport Richey, and it expanded, so now it covers all of Pasco County and even Hernando County. And it's grown. It has maybe 4,000 old photographs. I'm with the West Pasco Historical Society. I'm on the board of directors, and I've scanned all of their old photographs and photos we've borrowed. And I've looked through all the old newspapers we have at the museum in Newport Richey, and also newspapers in Dade City. And since I like doing web pages, I started doing an unofficial Gulf High School website in addition to the one done by the Media Center, which often is the people who do websites. And I guess they liked mine more than the official one, so they decided to have me do the official website. And I've been doing it since, I think, around the year 2002. And I try to update it almost every day. One nice thing about our website is the popular feature by Dr. Noble. Our principal, Dr. Steve Noble, records a weekly podcast, the principal's podcast. It's usually about 2 or 3 minutes long, and he ad-libs the thing with usually no notes, and he does it in one take. And it's a nice video that tells what's going on at the school. He updates the news and what's been happening, what's expected to be happening in the next week or so. So there's a weekly podcast on the school website, which seems to be popular. I also do, in addition to the school website, since I teach math and I'm interested in history, a website on the history of mathematics. Actually, it has two parts: history of mathematical symbols, and then the part that I put more effort into is the history of mathematical terminology. In other words, who coined a particular math term like logarithm, when it was first used, and, you know, we usually try to quote the source. I started the history of math websites, I think, in the 1990s, and it started out as a one-page little thing. And it's grown over the years. Now professors at major universities contribute things they've found in their libraries. So most of the updating of the History of Math website is really done by contributions. It's like a collaborative thing. And it's now a giant website. Each letter of the alphabet has its own page. And there are links all over the world to the website.